guys, welcome back to Embers and Ash. My name's Ashley, if you didn't know, and today I'm going to talk to you guys about thrifting. Now, this has been a topic that I've been avoiding for the past 2 months because I haven't been able to go thrifting, and a lot of you haven't been able to go thrifting, so I thought it wouldn't be very fitting if I talked about thrifting. But in my area, at least, our thrift stores are back open, and I've heard that other places in the world are reopening their thrift stores as well. So I wanted to talk to you guys about the mistakes that you make when thrifting so that when you can go back out there and restart your thrifting journey, you don't screw it up. And when I say screw it up, I just know that I have made some of these mistakes, or all of these mistakes, in the past and lost some money because of it, and I want to help prevent you from wasting your money. So the first mistake that I have made time and time again is buying clothes that don't fit but you will fix. Now, it can be so tempting to buy clothes that are like almost perfect because you so badly want them to be what you need them to be, and you tell yourself, oh, I'll get my grandma to fix this, I'll take it to the seamstress for that, but oftentimes that never really happens, and it just sits in your closet, and you don't ever use it. Now, this has changed for me a little bit since I've gotten a sewing machine, and I have been able to fix the clothes that I buy, so I'm more likely to buy clothes that aren't perfect, but it's because I know myself, and I know that I can easily fix things right now. If you know that you can't easily fix an item, don't bother. The second mistake that I have made a lot is that I buy something because there's nothing better in the store. I don't know what it is psychologically that makes me do this, but I'll go and pick out a bunch of stuff and I'll go try it on, or I'll grab it just to think on it, and if nothing better comes up, I will buy those few things. But I know for a fact that if I had found better items, I would have put those original ones back. I think maybe just because I don't want to feel like I wasted a trip or something, but now that I'm aware of it, I'm very conscious while I'm in the store, like, do I actually love this item, or am I just getting it because it's the best I can do? The third mistake is buying something that is too used or run down. Again, it can be very tempting to buy something because it checks all your boxes of what you were looking for, except for the fact that it's really overused. And then by the time, at least for myself, by the time I would get home with it and I've actually inspected the item a bit more, I realized, dang, maybe I shouldn't have done that. This might be a waste. And then next thing you know, in the next couple months, I'm re-donating it back to the thrift store because it wasn't up to the standard that I needed it to be. So basically, just try and really inspect the items that you're buying and check for flaws and the quality, because sometimes I'm a bit too quick to buy. The next mistake is when you are going to the thrift store and you have an idea of certain things that you need or want, and you try and buy it all in one trip. Maybe I'm just a very impatient person and that's what all this boils down to, but I really want to be able to get all the stuff that I'm looking for in one go, right? I don't think that's crazy. But most of the time with thrifting, it takes a lot of trips to a lot of different thrift stores to be able to get all the items that you're looking for. Otherwise, you're making compromises. So as nice as it would be and as time efficient as it would be to get everything in one trip, really don't compromise on the quality of the items that you're buying. The next mistake is buying clothes out of season. I still do this to this day, and I don't know why, because who knows what I'm gonna be into when that season does come around. I mean, I have a general idea, it's not like I'm a brand new person, but there's a chance that something better will come up in the meantime, or I'm not as into it as I was when I bought it. It's generally better to just leave those items for when that season comes up, because I think that there's this pressure that because it's a thrift store and there's only one of this item and it's only here right now, that you feel like, oh, I have to buy it now, and I will love it when that season comes. But I would not bank on that, promise me. And the last mistake kind of ties into all of these that I've talked about, and that is buying things just because it's cheap. Now, if thrift stores weren't as cheap as they are, I don't think as many of these mistakes would be happening as often, because a higher price can really deter you from buying things that are not perfect or poor quality or what have you. And this is something that I am continuously struggling with, where I'm like, oh, it's so cheap, I might as well get it. But nothing feels worse, in my opinion, than buying something from the thrift store and then a couple months later re-donating it and not having actually used it. Like, I basically gave the thrift store free money. flame. So just try and keep that in your mind. Don't buy something just because it's so cheap. So yeah, those are all the tips I have for you guys today. I really hope you can go out into the world, into your thrift stores, staying safe, and use them. If you liked this video, you might like my video where I showed you some of my spring outfits that I have going on that are majority thrifted, half thrifted. It's a toss-up. So go check that one out. Thanks again so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye!